I wonder if the sump is gonna be installed today. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a little bit of booty, and let's check it out.
Bible on the beat.
We got 'em going down for the count, looking at the ground. That's why we got haters. That's why we got haters. Haters everywhere we go. Haters everywhere we go.
What's going on, YouTube? It's Jay Wilson, JWilson07, Instagram, Twitter, Jay Wilson on Facebook, NorthFinUSA.com, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's get the sump rocking. Go! All right, so here I am rocking and rolling with the A-Round Nature Tank. I've got it off. I've got all of the tubing, all of the supplies, the tools, the screwdrivers, you name it, I got it, and that's what you should have. You don't want to be running around when you're trying to set up the sump, trying to figure out where something is. It makes for a tough process. So got the stainless steel clamp. We're going to get the clamp onto the bottom of the tank, which is where the barb is. I'm probably going to use terms you're not going to know and terms I may even make up. Remember, this is all a learning process. The key to this is very tight, not over tight. So you're not gonna use a piece of equipment to tighten this. You're gonna use just kind of strength. The only tough part with this is it is a round tank and it rolls. So I've gotta be careful not to crack the acrylic or scratch it. But with it being so light, it makes this job really, really easy. So we're getting the tube secured so that we can get it down the hole. If you look at the top of that stand, you can kind of see the cutout, and it's gonna drop right into the back of the tank from the return all the way to the drain pipe. So as you can see, I was looking for some tools and I have everything I need really close. You can see the shears that are down there to cut the tubing. And then I've got the pump already strung out, kind of sitting on the floor right there. The filter stock's in place for the most part. And we're just ready to get this thing together. So let's speed it up a little bit and we can talk a little bit more regarding how to get the tubing secure and what we're going to be doing moving forward. Once we've got this nice and tight, I made sure that I put a bead of silicone around the threading of the bulkhead to the barb. And then once we're done, we get it all secure, we're gonna put this right back on top of the stand. If you've got questions, leave them in the comments, but here I come, Hercules! Yes! Now the tough part is making sure the tubing gets in the hole while holding the A-Round Nature Tank. You would not do this with a glass tank unless you are Arnold Schwarzenegger in his prime during his Mr. Olympia days. But as you can see, this is a very manageable tank. One of the many reasons why I wanted to get this tank. If we're not using it anymore, we can definitely store it in an attic, somewhere that an overhead space because it is so light. So as you can see, there's some stuff inside the tank. That's the kind of the rules and regulations of how to run the tank and the warranty and how to clean it. But it's just me trying to figure out how to get this stupid tubing down through the hole. Now that we've got it all down there, it would really help if you had another person to kind of guide it down there. But at this instant, my wife was completely pregnant and it was not happening. So I'm just double checking to make sure that the bulkheads are tight, pull it down, got the tubing. One recommendation I would give you is make sure you do straighten out the tubing because my tubing was a little crimped and I had to use and I'll show you later on in this video, but I had to use a zip tie to make sure that it stayed wide open. So now I've just got the tubing where it needs to go. I'm going to hook the return tubing to the pump. It'll go right on top of the pump and I'll show you that later on and we'll discuss it a little bit. But literally, all I'm doing is cutting, fitting, and making sure everything is plumbed correctly. The worst thing you can do is rush this just to get a tank set up, only to find out that there was a leak somewhere. bingo, bango, bongo, that is exactly what happened to me. And once we get there, I will talk about it. So I've got the pump in the front of the sump. Now there's some ballasts in there and the ballasts are kind of what hold the water to where it needs to be held, whether you've got biomaterial, whether you're using mechanical filtration, whatever the case is. But the pump goes all the way in the front because when the drain drains the water back into the pump, into the sump, it starts to fill up each compartment. And once it overflows properly, it gets back towards the pump, which gets pumped back up through the return and into the tank. Pretty easy, pretty self-explanatory.
not something I'm used to. So we did have a couple of issues and we'll discuss them. So now I'm just making sure everything is tight. I've cut a nice piece of tubing right off. The tubing to the return was perfectly fine. It was the drain tubing that I actually had problems with, which caused a lot of air bubbles. And when I show you, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. But as I'm making this video right now, the tank, the sump, everything has been running flawlessly for a full week because, well, we had our child. So I wasn't able to do anything or maintenance it or clean it up or get it ready. So we're a little bit behind and I appreciate you bearing with me. So making sure you have all of the supplies you need. I've got everything. Today we're going to be using something different. I'm a huge Matrix guy and I'm now a huge Pinky Filters guy. But I don't want to ruin the Pinky's filter. So we're going to use this cheapo blue and white just to kind of filter out the nasty particles to get all of the unnecessary gunk, the sedatives. Once we start everything, we'll pull it out and put the proper media in place. So what I'm doing is just placing these in between where the drain comes in and where the pump pumps to the return. So this is literally in the center of the sump.
That'll just help with the fine filtering and bio like we talked about. So here's the marine pure in a bucket. It's got some water in it. Just rinsing it, letting it sit. And these things are like meatballs. This is the first time I'm trying it, as everybody knows I'm a CKM Matrix guy. But I'd like to try something different just to see if there is something better out there. Every once in a while, I will do this. So once I get this in the proper compartment, I was gonna try to dump it in. I don't think that worked out. But it's just meatballs all inside the biofiltration compartment of the sump. Make sure that you rinse thoroughly because there is a ton of sand inside that bucket, and I'm glad that I was paying attention and didn't dump it all in there. So now I'm gonna grab some more of the cheapo blue and white filtration pads, and I'm just gonna put them on top of it just to secure, make sure we get everything locked up and out of the sump and out of the tank. We don't want any sediment before we get crazy. There's a key to this whole thing, and I think people are going to fail to realize. Look at all of that sand. Gross. So clean, clean, clean. Now we're going to move on to filling this bad boy up. Well, most of you will ask, why are you not putting in your substrate and getting everything ready? Well, there's a reason. First off, I want to make sure that this thing does do what it's advertised to do. Hold water properly, no leaks. The sump works, no leaks. And the pump pumps the water back into the tank with no issues. So we're gonna speed this up, play a little bit of music, get it rocking, get it popping. Let's go!
Nothing can separate.
So if you're like me, it's completely new to this game, and water doesn't get down to the sump until it hits that grate. So the water has to be filled up in the tank first, let it do its drain, let it get to the consistency or the level that it needs to be at in the sump for it to start doing its normal operations. Now I'm going to show you two pictures. One is the sump before I start it, and the other is the sump after, as I'm filling it up to the necessary height as the tank had already done its draining.
All right, so here's the deal. We're kind of up and running for the most part. We've got water in it. It's not leaking. I did have a leak. Not going to lie. It was leaking from the return, and I had to actually take it off, siphon the back of the overflow, and kind of fix that. Clean off the silicone, put some Teflon tape and stuff on there, and get it all hooked up. I'm just testing it out, showing the lighting. We can do a couple different things with the light. Looks okay. But I'm still getting, so this is almost like, I'll call this a silencer. You hear the gurgling? There's air somewhere in here. I gotta figure it out, and it's somewhere down in here. I did put some foam back there, and maybe I've gotta take it out to redo it, but I've added some foam around the pump here. Nothing is set up properly right now as far as, you know, I've got a timer and things over here. I've got things plugged here. I'm just testing it, making sure it's all good before I start scaping and get everything ready for fish. So let's move to the next phase. All right, let's check out inside the sump before we end this video. But first, we've got a little bit of sediment on the bottom. That's what I was trying to prevent, a ton of it. So we're gonna have to clean that out, but we'll get that squared away. Now the neat part is, now you're gonna get to see inside the sump how I set it up. If we come up over the top over here, you'll notice that I've got the filter sock and there's just a lot of foam right now, which means probably air, but nothing's really going on. So I'm just glad it's all holding water. Now we've got the Marine Pure balls. The water is so clear, it looks like I can reach out and touch them. And that was the baffle that I was talking about. I said ballast in the video and I apologize, but the baffling right there, I was struggling to try to figure out what I needed to do to make sure the pump was getting the right amount of water. And that was making sure that I filled all of it up to that point right there. Let's get real close. As you can see, the water is going up over it, and then it comes down through that hole right there, which then gets sucked up by the water and back up. All right, folks, now you got to get an idea of how the water flows, where it goes, the sump, how it was set up. And the next step is just going to be getting everything ready to go, all of the fish, the substrate, the things of that nature. So stay tuned for the next video. Thank you so much for watching, liking, subscribing. You know the deal. You know what's next. Check out the Aquatic Lounge on Facebook because it is growing and it is awesome. Here comes Holla! Northfin USA will be giving away 100 grams of 1 millimeter marine formula. Zip tie I used to try to secure the tubing, so make sure you do something with your tubing. That sucks.